Okay, thank you all for attending and allowing me to tell a story that I think deserves to be told. It's a story that I love to tell to everyone who wants to hear it, whether it's people on a party, family, or politicians that we need to talk about when we talk about the future beyond COVID-19. But first, we need to get out of the situation where we are in. And for that, it is very important that we understand how UVC can play a role in improving the indoor air quality and inactivate airborne viruses such as SARS-CoV-2. In a previous version of this Academy series, we've seen Ed Nardell telling us stories here about the role of aerosol disinfections and the role of UVC. Also, articles studying all the cases in China. They showed that all the contaminations had happened indoor and not outdoor. This was also hinting very strongly at contaminations happening not just by droplets, because these could just as well happen in an outdoor setting. And then there was more and more evidence popping up. Here from the Irish Times, it says that outdoor transmissions account for 0.1% of COVID-19 cases. Super spreading events, primarily in prisons, meat factories, etc., they were happening indoors and not outdoors. So now moving on to UVC. UVC is a category of wavelengths between 100 and 280 nanometers, and that destroys the DNA or the RNA of microorganisms, such as viruses or bacteria. By that, they can no longer reproduce and they are inactivated. Here you see a picture of how it can be used in practice. And this is one possible application. It's the upper air mounted or upper wall mounted application of UVC, where the light, the UVC light, is only shown through the upper part of the room. So underneath the people, they will not be exposed to the UV light. Only the upper part of the room is being discontaminated. We've been expressing the effectiveness of UVC in terms of the dose. That's basically the energy that is received by this virus at a certain place in the location in joules per square meter. And this is the dose that determines the killing rate or the inactivation rate of the viruses. This depends on the exposure time, the wattage of the lamp, the design and optics of the luminaire, of course, and the geometries of the indoor environment. The safety standards are all in place. We've taken care of that, and they've been updated to enable broader use. And the first signs of government endorsement are there, so we hope that many governments will follow that example.